Now I will show you how to conduct an independent sample t-test in SPSS and how to compute a confidence interval for the difference between two population means. In this case, my purpose is to determine whether the female's performance on a certain test was statistically different than the male's performance on this test. So my null hypothesis is that in the population, the average test for females is equal to the average test for males, or the difference between the two average scores is equal to zero. My alternative hypothesis is that the average score for females is different, statistically different, than the average score for males on this test. So my two independent samples consist of females and males, respectively. But even though these two groups were selected independently from one another, I don't need to have two different files or to list the test scores under two different variables. I can have just one name variable that includes the identifier for every individual, female or male. Another variable, which in our case is called test, which lists all the test scores for all the individuals. But what I do need to have is a categorical variable which shows to which group each individual belongs to. So in our case, the two groups were selected based on gender. So the gender variable would be our grouping variable. I use the value 1 for females and the value 2 for males. To compute the confidence interval and to conduct the test of significance, I have to go to the Analyze menu and then click on Compare Means and choose Independent Samples T-Test. And both of these analyses will be conducted in just one step. On the left side, I have a list of all the variables in my data set, and I have to choose the variable that I am testing across groups. In our case, this variable is test scores, so I click on test scores and then click on this arrow, and I can see here that my test variable is now test scores. I also have to tell SPSS which one is my grouping variable. In our case, our grouping variable is gender. So I click on gender and then click on this arrow. I also have to tell SPSS which values indicate which group. So I have to click on Define Groups. And for group 1, I have value 1. This is the females group. And for group 2, I have the values 2. So I am testing the difference between group 1, females, and group 2, males. Females minus males. This is a nice coincidence that I have value 1 for group 1 and 2 for group 2. But if I use a different coding procedure, like for instance 0 for females and 1 for males, I would have put 0 here and 1 here. So now I can click continue. And I also have to tell SPSS the confidence level for the confidence interval for the difference between the two means. So to do that, I have to click on options. And by default, SPSS estimates the 95% confidence interval for the difference. But let's say that we want the 90% confidence interval for the difference between the two means. So I type 90 here and then click continue. And now I can click OK. In my output window, I now have two tables. The first table is a descriptives table. I can see my two groups here, females and males. For each group, we have the sample size 8 and 12. the mean or the average test score for each group, I can already see that females have a higher score than males, and then the standard deviation and standard error for each group. The results of the test of significance are provided in this area, under the t-test for equality of means section. SPSS also tests the assumption that the variable has equal variances in the two populations. If the significance value for this test provided here is lower than 0.05, then we should use the results provided in the second row of this table. If this significance value is larger than 0.05, then we should use the values provided in the first row. The results of the test of significance are provided in this columns. We see that the test statistic is 3.27, so it is a positive value, which tells us that the mean for females is larger than the mean for males. And the p-value for this test statistic is 0.005. The mean difference between the two groups is 10 points. These results tell us that if the null hypothesis is true, that is, if in the population the two average scores are truly equal, then there is only a 0.005 probability of obtaining a mean difference of 10 points. Because this p-value is lower than the alpha level of 0.05, we can reject the null hypothesis and accept the alternative hypothesis that the mean in the population of the two groups are statistically different. The confidence interval for the difference between the two groups is provided here. We can see here that the confidence level is 90%, and we can say with 90% confidence that the difference between females and males in the population on this test is somewhere between 4.64 points and 15.35 points.